Just moved in my new house today. Moving was hard, but I got squared away. Bell started ringing and chains rattled out. I knew I'd moved in a haunted house. Still I made up in my mind to stay. Nothing was gonna drive me away.
Well, welcome to March 14th. Had something to vlog, so I figured I'd get the camera out and vlog. First off, wanted to show you guys that pile there. You can tell by the coloring, and we'll get over here. These are the panels I've been working on since November. Finally, life is calming down enough where I had the free time and I was able to power build or power paint, you know, and get the rest of the panels done. But that is represents right there my first prop for the season. I've got 40 panels sitting there, 42-foot wide panels and 2 1-foot panels in that stack. So first prop of the season off my checklist. It's done. In the process right now trying to get my shop kind of cleaned up. It's kind of a disaster area. Probably gonna stay a disaster area because I still can't get back in my storage locker to get things put away. But you will notice stacks of foam here has gone down considerably. It was all the way out to the door here, and that's because I just took in 40 more sheets, 41 more sheets actually, into my workbench in the house. That's right, more card foam coming up here, guys. The panels I just finished are for my gypsy display that we do. What I'm getting ready to work on now is our witches display. I'm going to carve up 42-foot panels and 2 1-foot panels for that display. And actually going over my blueprints this year that I drew out for my haunt, I only need about 32 panels for the witches display. I'm over carving. The wife and I got to talking and we were thinking it's better to keep everything at 40. That way we have extra panels in case something gets damaged. We can use them. We always have little sections like last year or something. We had the ghost hallway. You know, we could put extra panels into that. You know, what have you, if we have a lot left over. So we're going to do 40 panels for that one. The pattern I went and chose, it's going to be similar to the ones I just did. It's going to have the wainscoting on the bottom, wallpaper on the top with the chair rail. Now what we decided to do for the wallpaper was this design here, a diamond shaped with this pattern kind of offsetting it. And I know it's kind of hard to visualize. Believe me, by the end of the vlog, you'll get the idea. I'll have a few panels sketched out and you'll be able to see the pattern a little bit. But that there is going to be for the wallpaper. Now for the chair rail, instead of just doing cracks across it like I did on the panels I just finished, wife suggested doing some detail work in there. And we came up with this skull. So we're going to have a roll. Tentative plans right now is to have a row of skulls going across that chair rail. So, you know, that's what we're getting ready to do, I guess, for this project. Right now, I've got it out here. And here, get over here with these. You know, this is the wallpaper pattern I did for the panels I just finished. I printed out the pattern and then glued it. It's some 1/8-inch thick glue on. I've got, and then drilled out, you know, cut out the pattern. I'm going to do the same thing with these, both the skull and these two, you know, to make up some templates. It makes it easier for sketching out. So, getting ready to kind of do that. Hey, welcome to March 15th. Yesterday, I kind of covered on what we're doing. I'm starting on another set for the witches display. Did a little work out in the shop, got my panels into my basement work area, and started last night with sketching out the pattern. One of the things I did before I get on to what I ended up sketching out, wanted to cover the stencils. Ended up with these here. This one here and this one here I'm going to be using to do the wallpaper. These here I'm going to be using on the wainscoting on the bottom of it for doing damaged areas. And then I got on the internet, decided I was going to add some skulls to a chair rail. The last set I did had a chair rail with wallpaper and wainscoting on. I like the chair rail feature, so I decided I was going to repeat that. Instead of doing cracks down the length of it like I did with the other panels, I said I'm going to add those skulls to it. So I got everything laid out, cut out, what have you. And those are some of the elements, along with rulers, pencils, and what have you, I'm going to be using to sketch a pattern out. Now, yesterday, before we did Diablo's chat on Google Hangout, I went through and I got this. And I know it looks like a disaster. That's my first panel. Every time I do these panels, the very first sheet is always a disaster because I'm changing things and stuff on there. But you can see the basic layout. You know, you got your large pattern, and I've got the small pattern in there, series of cracks. I did go through, and you can tell, like down here, you can see some faint lines and stuff. You know, I sanded off the lines I had and did some adjustments, what have you. We ended up adjusting the damage area on that, and we're going to end up adjusting the damage areas on here. I did not sand the detailing down on the cracks, because if I do, it's going to wipe out my pattern for the wallpaper. So I'll manually mark that out when I'm ready to carve that panel. Then once it's painted, you won't even see the ink lines. But that is pretty much the first panel. Now, from the first panel, we'll go over to this panel, and you can get a better idea of the wallpaper design and stuff on here. That set, it's all measured out into space and is good for carving. On the first panel, you notice I have about eight cracks, four from the top, four from the bottom. We decided with the print on the wallpaper, having that many cracks, it just made it look too busy. So we decided to cut it down to two cracks per panel on the top. And we ended up, I'll end up varying these from panel to panel. The cracks will be a different shape, what have you. So there'll be a little variance there. The chair rail, you can see a little bit better as well, I think, with my lighting the way it is. Let's angle the light more that way. So you can see the chair rail. You got the skulls here. Now you notice I have a wide band here. I'm going to do like I did on the other panels and have that ridge look, ridge trim, I guess is a better word. Sorry, I'm stumbling over words today for some reason. But we'll have that around that down. And then the wainscoting and stuff, on that panel, I ended up doing three cracks. I am going to be modulating the cracks on the wainscoting so they won't be in the same spot. Some might only have one set of cracks on it, others will have three. I might do some with two. You know, I'll just vary them, you know, so all the panels look kind of unique. But that's kind of what I'm working on now. I'm probably going to be spending the next week or so, depending on time and everything, getting all the panels sketched out. So I've got 40 panels to sketch out, which are back over there. And it's going to take a while. I'll probably get half of them sketched out, carve them, then come back through and do the other half. So it's kind of tentatively the plans now. Next segment, you'll get a look at the a couple of these panels carved out. So it'll be interesting to see what they look like. But that next segment will probably, for you, will be just a couple of seconds. For me, it's going to be about a week from now. There will be about a week delay between filming. So Anyway, at least now you guys are getting a better idea of what I'm doing. Well, it's a week later. Actually, it's not a week later. It's later the same day on the 15th. Or actually, it's the 16th. Excuse me. Another little bit for you here. Did a design change. As you can see, the top part is pretty much the same. I still got my pattern on, and I know it doesn't show up well from a distance, so I have to get close. I got my cracks on the upper part, one coming down from the top, one coming up from the bottom. Or actually not the bottom, but from the chair rail. Chair rail's the same. What I did change, though, however, was the bottom. My planking here is still the same as it was before when I showed it to you. What I decided to do was change how I was doing the cracks on it. Before, get on over here, I had, you know, some silhouettes I cut out, patterns I cut out, sawtooth. And I was doing cracks off the points. I got to looking at it, it just didn't look right, it didn't feel right. You know, so on a couple of the other panels I did, I went and took some sandpaper and lightly went over the crack here to kind of erase it and then redrew it on with pen, which showed up darker. That way I wouldn't get confused when I was cutting it and cut the wrong thing. And the more I looked at it, I liked the look. And I'll go with this one here, I just got it finished. Oh, the sanded look on here. It actually gives it more of a wood grain style pattern, especially when painted, because I sand it all in the same direction. And, you know, there's some high spots, some low spots. I'm thinking I'll probably eventually end up painting this brown, and then I can go back with a yellow or a gold or maybe a different shade of brown and do a dry brush on it. And with those raised spots and the scratches, should give more of a veining look. If I decide to go that far, haven't yet. So I did that, you know, did the sanding, and I got to thinking, I thought I'd carry the crack pattern from the top down below, but instead of just doing two big ones, I figured I'd do three. And what I'm doing is, like on this panel, I've got two cracks starting at the bottom of the plank and one starting from the chair rail. The next panel I do, I'll flip it. I'll have two running from the chair rail and one from the bottom. And alternate. That way it makes it look a little different. But, so I decided to do that. So I've gone back through all my panels. They've all been sanded. And then all the cracks have been redone to match this pattern. That very first panel I showed you that was a mess, it's even more of a mess now. But once it's carved and been painted, you won't even see all the ink lines and stuff. But, so, right now we've got the bottom on the wainscoting here, sanded. We got the longer cracks on it, which I like. It just didn't look right with the cutouts the way I had it. We got the skulls on the chair rail, and it's set up to do that raised trim on the chair rail. And then we got the wallpaper with two cracks, and there's two different patterns I added to it. All in all, these panels, even though that wallpaper section is fairly intricate, there's a lot to it. All in all, I think the carving is going to be a lot easier on these panels and a lot quicker, because there's actually a lot less going on. On the other panels I did, the top part was, you know, complicated because of the wallpaper pattern. This hasn't changed. The top on these is complicated. The chair rail is a little bit more complicated with the skulls on it, but they should go fairly quick. The wainscoting, however, I had, you know, the cracks, the damage for the eyes, and I had that bone pattern I did on them, you know, all of which had to be carved, what have you. You know, and I recessed it, you know, a little bit, you know, so the bone pattern and stuff stuck out, which meant I did a lot of carving on that section. On this one, all I could do is just carve out the lines to separate the planks and do the cracks, and that's, you know, like a 5 minute, maybe 10 minute job. So the lower half will go a lot quicker, and that will actually cut time down. Now, how long is it going to take to carve? I don't know yet. You'll find out when I get to that point where I'm carving. I'm not there yet. So, but I did want to show you, you know, what I ended up coming up with for the design. All the rest of the panels will be done in this fashion. So, with that being said, I'll see you in a week. And for you, it's actually, I'll see you in a couple of seconds. But for me, it's going to be about a week. It's going to take me a while to get all 41 panels carved out, or laid out. I'm going to get them all laid out before I start doing any sort of carving. Hey, people. It's March 17th. It's only been a couple of days. I told you I'd have another update for you about a week my time, and the next segment would show the update. Well, no major update. I'm still sketching. I've got about 13 panels sketched out of 41. Got half of one done here on the table. Wanted to bring up, this isn't about the project. Today being March 17th is my birthday. And by the time you see this, it's probably going to be a week or two past my birthday. But was it a nice feeling today opening up my email and seeing all the birthday wishes from a lot of you guys out there. And I posted a thank you on Facebook, but I wanted to give you a verbal one. Thank you. It was touching to see everyone sending their birthday wishes today. So, thank you. I'm touched. And you guys gave me a lot of emails to read today. And a lot of neat posts. Some of the cards and videos and everything. So, see you on the next segment. And again, thank you for the birthday wishes. Hey, people. What's been just a couple of seconds for you from the last segment to this segment, for me, has been a little over a week. Now, I've showed you these here. And this is our panels. I've got all 40 of them sketched out. You know, they're ready for carving. And I've got a bunch already started on the carving. I wanted to show you those. Now, what you haven't seen from this has gone to this. And here are some of them carved out. And I know lighting is not the best down here. You'll be able to see more of the detail once they're actually painted. But we got our wainscoting down there. We got alternating cracks with them. We've got our chair rail, which is a detail from the other panels I did that you saw. I'm going to zoom that back out. I didn't realize I had it zoomed in. And then we've got our wallpaper pattern with some cracks running through it. Now the panels themselves take about 2 hours to carve. The chair rail and then down below is roughly about 30 minutes to carve that. The other hour and a half is doing the wallpaper, and that's because of the pattern on the wallpaper. Now, when I buy my foam, I buy it down at Home Depot most times. It's a tongue and groove style foam. In other words, it has a groove on one side and a notch on and a tab on the other side. When I go to cut out my panels are slightly wider than they need to be, just because of that groove. Now, as a result, here on the seam, if you notice here, everything kind of lines up. Or you know, that's fine, one doesn't have a crack in it. There we go. Kind of lines up. When you go over next to the seam, this half of the box is slightly smaller than this side of the box. And that's because that bigger section is right where a groove is. Now, when I go to put these on the panels on my wall frames before I paint them, I'll do a test fit, you know, to mark out where all the screw holes go before I paint. I'll take my rasp and I'll go over this edge and take off some of this material down the edge. When it does that, it'll shrink up this square so it'll match here a little bit better. Because right now, as you notice, it's Or like here, for example, one side's slightly bigger than the other side. And once you get painted, it'll show. So I'll knock that down when I test it, when I do my test fits and stuff out in the shop. So that will be taken care of. As far as work, as I stated earlier, I have 42-foot by 7-foot panels, and instead of having the camera cock, how about if I have it sitting straight up? It's been a while. I've gotten away from being used to running the camera. But anyway, I've got 42-foot wide by 6-foot 11¾, 7-foot, we'll just say 7-foot in height panels, and I've got 2 1-foot panels. Currently, I've got 10 of the 2-foot panels carved and both the 1-foot panels carved. Maybe not, but you can see over there, hopefully. I've still got a couple of big stacks of foam to carve. It's going to take me a couple of weeks to get these carved. But, so basically that's all I'm working on right now, is just doing some carving. Once I get halfway through the panels, I'll go and take, I'll take the first half out. I'll start getting the base coats and stuff on them. While I'm working on the other half, getting them carved. I think for now, it's been almost a month since I've uploaded something. I'm going to go ahead and bring this vlog to a close. You guys have a really good idea now what I'm working on, what I'm doing. Next vlog, which will probably be out in about a month, the way I'm going, is going to be covering the painting on these panels. Some of the different steps. The steps are pretty much the same as with the last panel, so I probably won't do it in how-to style. I'll just, get the camera. Hey, I've gotten this far done. This is what this looks like. And do a standard vlog on them. But anyway, that's what I'm working on. And we're getting closer to being done. So with that, I'm going to say good day, goodbye, hasta la vista, see you later. Stay spooky out there.